don't care. You can call me by my name. You can call me by my username. I'm fine either way.
All right, so I'll just call you Carl then. If that's all right with you.
Yeah, it's fine.
All right, cool. All right, this is Kyle, everyone.
Hey.
We're going to play the Dirty, Dirty Lizard Men.
Oh, man. I see so many people playing Lizard Men because they think it's free wins. And it is because people do not focus on skinks. If you don't focus on skinks, Lizard Men are going to run all over you. Their linemen are cheap and they are strong. So they'll just, you know, run all over you.
Right, so... Since this is a new recording, no one has any injuries or anything like that. We got a new cow. His name is Plowman's, because, you know, Plowman's crisp. That is a sandwich. It's a farmer's sandwich. They made it into a crisp flavor, or chip flavor in America, I suppose. So, yes.
The thing about Saurus is they're as strong as a black orc with one less agility, and they got more movement allowance. They can move six. So it's like... They're really strong. Having six of them, there's not much you can do against them. You don't want to just go full bash against a bunch of swords. Welcome back to Cabal Vision. Mess you up.
So we want to tie up the Sauruses, right, and then just pound the skinks, right? That's the kind of theme of this sort of match.
Think of it as it being elf bullshit without action. We should get some today, because they have movement allowance 8, which is only one less than a Skaven Gutter Runner. They can have up to 16 skinks. And they have dodge and stunty. What stunty is, if your viewers don't know, if they go through tackle zones, they ignore the minus rolls.
Oh, really?
Yes, so you can see a skink just running through a ton of tackle zones, because it has dodge and stunty. So they can just pass your stuff.
Well, I don't know if you've seen the stream, but the Lizard Men do look rather impressive since it's the new
team.
They
have great animations.
Mm.
Also, if you're trying to dodge around, they have a Krogzgor, don't do it. Prehensile Tail will trip you up. If you're an elf, you don't want that.
My old coach used to say, keep a Saurus inside your tackle zone. It's been a
bane of my existence.
You'll have difficulty breaking away.
Put the big guy up front. Who doesn't have any SPP?
Oh, good, they don't have any croc scores. It's great.
That's fantastic. It's good for me, anyway.
Croc scores are so strong. I mean, that prehensile tail will... Oh, my God.
I do notice that they don't have many skinks. They only have about 5 skinks, I think. They might have more on the bench, but
You usually want just about 4 skinks, because that's what you'll be doing anyways. Your skinks are running your touchdowns, you don't need that many.
Yeah.
The only, most people will look at Stunty and say it's overpowered. The only redeeming factors on Stunty that doesn't make it overpowered is the fact that the player gets injured more easily and they cannot pass or catch.
Yeah.
I think most halfling teams have Stunty, if I'm remembering correctly.
Yeah, I think all of the short ones do, including Gobbos as well. They have stunty. It's anyone that's basically half sized.
Gobbos have secret weapons too, though. That makes gobbos a whole lot of fun.
Yeah, I like throwing goblins at people most of the time to sort of like use them as the weapon. It's sort of like, you know.
Wait till ogres come in. A bunch of ogres and snotlings.
Yeah. That's one of the teams I think people are really looking forward to. They're kind of a bit of an underpowered team,
All the teams are meant to be even. That's one thing that you get in these computer games that will make a lot of people just complain, is they think everything to be equal and viable.
Sure.
No, you don't want halflings to be on the same level as orcs or dark elves. That's not how it was meant to be played. And if someone's unhappy about that, it's because they don't understand. A coach chooses halflings to have a more difficult time.
Basically, yeah.
Using it as your own difficulty.
Yeah, I mean, people seem to get really salty about, the random dice, you know? You can either laugh it off, or, you know, you can get really angry about it and, make a lot more bad decisions, you know? That's how I view it.
People will just go off on a tangent and lose it.
Yeah.
Oh, man. One of those linemen have a fucking guard ability. But those skinks are now in the perfect position to be messed up.
Yeah, I am. Don't worry, I've noticed this as well. I'm actually gonna fuck them up. But first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stand everyone up. Oh. At least I thought I was going to stand everyone. No, I'm not going to re-roll it. Just... Sometimes
cute animals like he has a loner, doesn't he? You're talking about the big guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wild Animal is actually a better ability than Bonehead. Because Wild Animal, if it goes with Wild Animal, if it's standing up, it still has its tackle zones and it will still attack.
Sure.
Bonehead will not do that.
I'll follow. I got blocked.
That has dodge. I would have rerolled that, but that's just me.
Yeah.
Three die blocks are usually worth rerolling. Oh, you have guard. That's. Oh, you attacked a star player. You have to hover over that star player and see what he has. I'm actually quite interested.
He has. Jump up, which is very good. Stab. Oh my god, he's an assassin. Stunty.
A stab skink.
Yeah. Block and.
Runs to your back line, stab someone.
Oh yeah. That is going to be fucking amazing. Like, okay. You have block, so I'm going to put you here.
Oh, he has sidestep. Damn.
He has quite a few things.
But yeah, you do not want to engage those croxagores, those lion lizards. They're never worth it.
No.
They can dish out pain on you.
I'm literally going to put you here for now. Okay, so after turn one, we figured out they have a star player, which... Stab failure. Okay. Motherfucker tried...
Figure it out now.
Motherfucker tried to stab me.
Getting up close and personal. Oh, man.
Need to be close. So close they can smell your breath and see the dead insects in your teeth.
Oh, I just can't wait till all your warriors get blocked. It's gonna be great.
Yeah, it's a thing, isn't it? It's either block or guard, really, isn't it? Yeah. Okay.
Most cases you actually want block with your Chaos Warriors. Guard's probably the secondary thing you pick up. Just because you want the blocks you're throwing to have a higher chance of knocking the enemy.
All right, so the skinks are lining up for me, which is tasty.
Oh, I hope you can kill them. It'll be a win. You'll win this game if you kill skinks.
Yeah.
Because there's they have two on reserve. The AI's smarter than most people. Because I can't tell you how many games I've played where I've played against lizardmen that they've just conceded because they couldn't play anymore. Because you just blitz their skinks, kill their skinks, and then they can't. Those swords are agility one. There's no way in hell they're picking up that ball.
Sure. Well, I'm gonna follow up because it'll be even though they got stunty, I still want. To push these guys. Oh my god, I'm just getting like a load of pushes here, but.
Don't worry. You'll get something good eventually. Iron Jesus will be on your side.
Pride indeed.
Right, those pushes.
I know, there's a lot of. But I don't want to burn a lot of rerolls. I'm hurting the star player, and. He's on the floor now, which is great.
If you can get a chance, foul them if you have a loner or anything.
I don't at the moment, currently, unfortunately. I'm trying to figure out a good way of getting around to the skinks.
That's a holding maneuver, if ever I saw one.
I'm going to re-roll that one, actually. I'm kind of needing to be down. But of course I get a double block down, but never mind. Oh, I injured him. Worth it.
I'll see it. I'm no use in me asking. That armor value 7 really helps.
Yeah. I mean, like, it was a both down. It was the last person on my thing. So, like, you know, looping up for Nuffle. So,
might as well. Yeah.
It killed one of the skinks. So that's kind of what we do, I suppose.
All you need is to kill three more and four more, and then they're banned players, and you've won.
They got a bit of a. Oh, sorry.
It's the most annoying, awful thing in this game.
Sure.
Fucking swords that have block. They're so strong. It's like, oh my god, what do I do?
So like block and guard, right, is what you would want?
Yes, if you got block and guard on your swords, it's mean. There's not much you can do against it.
The Mu Cow's taking a bit of a pounding, but...
God, they just keep trying to stab your players.
They do. That Assassin Skink is actually really cool, because he wasn't in the last Blood Bowl game as a star player, because they didn't have them all, which is a bit annoying. But, like, you know, having him as a star player, that's actually a really cool thing.
Is that Hemlock Skink?
Let me click on him.
He's on him now, like a halfling on a hot dinner.
Is it Arsenic, I think? The fucking writing's very small, but...
That's not the star player that I see on my rules book, so that must be a cyanide name.
Yeah, sure. Now, do we pound this guy into dust with a free block die?
Is the assist going to be enough to come out on top?
A free roll. Yay, some pals. We did it.
Wow, three pushes that first roll. Oh my god.
This player likes to be well assisted in fight.
Uppercut his ass. Alright, so we're doing a little bit of the bash game. I've made a little bit of a tunnel for myself. I still have a blitz, so I'm going to go for it.
Probably going to want to blitz, the carrier.
Gone into the opponent's tackle zone.
You can.
Should be good.
I'm literally... No, I couldn't because it was too far away, but what I'm doing
too
is...
Too many tackle zones, too.
Yeah. What I'm doing is I'm getting next to him, which doesn't help that much, but it helps enough, if that makes any sense. So, come on, get up. There we go.
Don't rely on tackle zones. They'll do some shit that'll make you just rage.
Yeah, alright. So... But, what's going on now is, what do I do with this guy here? I think I might pull him out a little bit. That's a one die block. It's also a one die block. I think I'm just going to end my turn for now, because I want to I don't want to get into a punching contest with the big ones. So
no, you do not. That is that's
on,
bad
guys.
Times ahead.
Team spirit is the key. Well, except for me. That player's bouncing up faster than an inflated squig.
He is going for all the stabs. One die block. I mean, I'm really impressed with the animations in this one. I don't know if you ever see some video of the Corn Demons in Blood Bowl, the original Blood Bowl game. Like, oh my god, the walking animation for the actual Corn Demon himself is the funniest thing you've ever seen in your life.
Is it like clipping or something?
His wings? I don't know. It looks like he's running with like he's just soiled himself or something. Like, you know what I mean? It's just kind of like, and his wings, like, oh my god. They couldn't animate wings properly, so like it looks really fucking strange. Like,
okay, I'll have to definitely pull that up and check that out.
Yeah, if you ever watch any of Kanor's streams and stuff, it's like,
you won't leave him alone anytime soon.
I am not re-rolling that. Go, Mu Cow. The Plowmans.
Just wait till he can level that cow up. It'll be one of the best investments you've gotten. Though I do not, for like new players, new teams, I do not recommend them getting an early Minotaur. It's just too expensive to justify. And like, if you're playing against normal players and you're not in an AI league,
sure,
people will target that cow.
Yeah, I know. Guys,
together. I've been turn four fouled on my cow. And I'm like, whoa, there's bad manners. And then there's fuck this piece in particular.
Well, you know, that's how it works, though, isn't it? Like, you always take out the bad. The pieces that you don't like. It's the way it works, you know?
If it's in an open league, it's a whole lot worse than if it's a just closed league. Because
sure,
if you know you're going to be playing against them again, then yes, that's totally viable. Get that piece off the board, because they're just going to become stronger with time, playing against other people in your league. But if you're just playing a random match, no way, that's almost unexcusable. Like, I can understand stunning them out of the match, but just fishing for injuries. Just
one more step. That's one KO. Goodbye, sweet prince.
Rest in peace.
And it wasn't the skink either, it was a fucking one of the big dudes, so that's alright.
I know, and their armor value is like, I think it's 8, 9.
I'm gonna stay. I want them base, but I don't want them near each other. So
when you finish this leak, play some lizard men. They have some of the most, it's like a perfect mixture of elf bullshit and dwarf bullshit.
Yeah, did you watch the co-optional like league where like Krendel was playing as the elf lizard men? That like he got like a lot of
I've had
skink luck, but
I've
like
had enough people to say the name Little Skittles that I eventually had to.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, those rolls! Some of those rolls were just obscene.
Yeah, right. He's the sort of he had like fucking skink luck all the way, but you can't get mad about it. Like, you know, it's just.
Well, no, you can. If you get mad at it, then it's like, well, why are you playing a random legion? Why are you playing a game that has random elements?
Sure.
Something that, you know.
Go play something casual. You know?
Not even casual, it's just like, okay, you want something more structured? Then, you know, move away from the randomness. Because if you know the randomness is going to bring the salt out, then you gotta expect, though. You gotta expect the worst and hope for the best.
Indeed. I couldn't have put it better myself. Because what my philosophy is, if I always expect the worst, you know, then it can only go up from there, right? So like,
I was playing against one of my friends the other day, and he's playing Skaven, and I'm just playing humans. By the, like, turn seven, seven of his Skaven linemen were injured, and his gutter runner was dead, because he used an apoth on one of his injured linesmen, because he thought, well, you know, that's probably the worst one. But no. God, no. He lost so many people.
And everybody died.
Almost. I was, at that point, I wasn't even fouling, because I'm like, you know what? No, you're already down in crippled. It's gone. It's over.
That's a nice play, you know? Like, there are people that will be like, oh.
It's already, if he's already down, there's no need to kick him. He's done. He's no longer a threat.
Sure.
Plus, I don't want to lose my player. Fuck it, I'm going to give him a ball and I'm just going to trudge him up the field because there's nothing you can do about it and give him free SPP.
Besides, fouling doesn't give you any SPP, so you want to be sort of careful fouling anyway. It's not something
you want to use fouling as risk management. Like, how big of a problem is that player going to be for you, and how many plays do you think they're going to make with him?
Sure. So,
unless you're playing vampire counts, then you know what? Foul their thralls. Get their thralls out of there. The field.
I was playing a vampire team once. Oh, Irish Stew is injured.
Yep, I reckon that's what he'd say. If he
badly hurt.
Talk.
Sorry, matey. You're getting the rest of the day off.
Don't worry, just walk it off.
Not using APOC on that shit. But guess who? Where the moo cow's next to?
Oh yeah, it's time for some death.
Moo cow. Actually, no.
Don't wild animal.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, moo cow, be nice to me. Like, I treated you good. I haven't called you any bad names today. I'm gonna do the three dice block first, though. Yeah, there we go. It's got dodge, but we can live with that. Follow. Right, there's...
They're attacking the ball carrier, Bob.
Oh!
Watching the same match as you.
I already rolled that myself.
We rolled it?
Yeah, the three dice block one.
Oh, yeah, maybe. But then again, if I can do some elf bullshit in the last turn to get a touchdown or something, then...
Because the thing is, you're close to the 8th, and you're going to get all your rerolls back, so now you can burn a couple.
Yeah, yeah. I'm definitely going to start playing a little bit more risque. Right. I really want a power. I want to kill this guy.
But you've done pretty good not getting scored on by this man.
Oh. With the fairies. Better watch out. Stephen Fry up. Murderous little bee. Hang on. You're literally the worst.
Look at that thing. Yes, the unmistakable sign of a player's eyes rolling up into his head.
Oh, and he got KO'd.
I know.
Damn.
Not what you'd expect. That is surprising. You filled the pickup, which is unusual for a skink.
Yeah, I'm trying to think, what is their agility? I think the skink's agility is 4? No, 3.
Right, so, 7th turn. Do the less dangerous ones first. Get the skinks out of the way.
Yes.
Push them. Follow. Okay. Chaos guy. It's only a tour, but we can still manage that. I have... Oh no, I don't have to reroll that. What the fuck am I doing? God damn it. I keep doing stupid shit like that. It's not going to help me.
Like I said, slow your roll. Don't just choose things too quickly.
Yeah.
Contemplate your actions.
It's... Oh, of course you wild animal. Why make it easy on me? Alright. Alright. Okay, I pounded this guy into dust.
I've been trying to wrap my head around the Bretonians.
They are wrestle. Oh, like, you can get the ball off them. Oh, hello. This is a bit of spot of luck.
Absolutely.
Can I see how much he can do? I think I might score. Hooray!
Wow. And he doesn't have any points, too, so good person to put it on.
Stamp on that skink. Make sure he doesn't get up, because he's the only one that can actually get hold of me right now.
Oh, you got sent off. I can hear it.
Yep.
You can't be guild affiliated.
It was worth it. I think, personally. It was only a chaos guy anyway, so sorry, a normal player.
Beast man.
Yeah. I usually don't foul. It's not my style, but like I really wanted to make sure that he was...
Playing Bretonians, they're so easy to foul with because I can always get a couple extra linemen because they're so damn cheap. And I just surround a person with linemen and I just stomp them.
Sure.
Not a wise place to end your turn on the border of the pitch.
Oh, you felt it going for it. And he's got a loner. It's a star player. Amazing. Nuffle's on my side. Thank you, Nuffle. Alright, I'm just going to run this in. I'm not going to do anything fancy.
Man, so far so good.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm learning that, like, just punching people in the face, you got... you kind of need to move your pieces around first, which I think was what I was doing wrong before.
Hope they add in some new stadiums in the next patch.
Maybe.
Because, I mean, starting with 8 teams and 5 stadiums seems a little wonky to me. I think they're rushing to get it out.
Yeah, you don't have, like, the Underworld Stadium, which is going to be... Like, the Underworld Stadium in the original Blood Bowl game was actually a pretty cool stadium.
There was the Doom Bell and the Skaven Stadium. Nice touch.
Wakey, wakey. One team's got some early knockouts back.
Okay, so how many people has he got out?
Now that they're outnumbered.
The best defense is a good offense.
Okay, the Krog, one of the stronger pieces, Asarin, he's still knocked out. He's not coming back.
That'll give you more chance to get to that, those freaking skinks.
Yeah. It would, wouldn't it? Alright, so what are you? Welsh Were-Rabbit, you've leveled up. Don't know how, but you have. Right, I'm going to keep the block guy on the line.
Hey man, I'll never be one to spit in the face of free level ups.
No. Don't get me wrong. I'm not complaining. It's just I'll put you... No. Don't go there, actually. Actually, Cal. Could you move, please? Cal. There we go. Alright, so... Where's my Shorehands? Shorehands and agility guy. Alright, so where's the Shorehands guy gone? Was that the guy that got sent off? It was. Alright, fair enough. Shouldn't have done that then.
You know what? No, he's safe. Now you don't have to worry about him getting fouled.
Oh, that's also very true. You're correct. Okay, so the agility guy is going to have to be on the Eye of Sauron then.
It's actually pretty good against dwarf teams if they're going to just grinder you and try to kill your players. Foul theirs and hope you get caught. It saves some of your key pieces.
Especially with it being murderous bastards. Oh, he actually hits it with his tail. That's a really cool animation. That's not bad. It's not bad.
But yeah, people hate Lizardmen right now. If the Slan got in the game, they would be unhappy.
His fist is approximately the same size as his entire opponent.
Oh, you're gonna pay. KO'd. Straight away.
I see that.
That's the best part, right? Really, don't let them. They're massive and can take your hand right off.
Oh, I can't remember. KOs get SPP, right?
No. They don't, actually. KOs are the only thing that take the people out of the game that don't give you SPP, unfortunately. Which is a shame, but it would mean that you would level up like 5 million times quicker, because like, if you were playing an elf team, you're just knocking everyone out. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it'd just be...
But this still is the injury table roll.
Yeah, but it's the most politest of injury table rolls, if you know what I mean. It's kind of like,
You control your injury table rolls, though. There's no being polite.
Yeah.
It's not like you're like, I'll choose this injury off the table.
No, that's true. But
world, I'm a guarantee Chaos players would always choose death. Oh, he's killed.
They're gathering around that lone player, like halflings round a sandwich.
Well, I've heard a little bit of rumbling on the forums that they're not going to add the Nurgle team, and that will make me a little sad, but you know.
Actually, what it is they found, like, the avatar pictures for all of the teams that they're going to add in the thing, and Nurgle's picture wasn't on there.
You'll get an assist.
It doesn't mean that that they're not going to be on there. It just means...
Yeah, maybe someday, but I hope so.
Because the Slan aren't on there either.
Three players off of Nurgle's team's the best.
Yeah.
Nurgle's rot. So fun.
I think it's because of the AoE stuff that people think is a little bit bullshit, but I don't know.
That's it. Get in their face.
Like, I don't see why people complain so much about, like, vital core game rules from the board game. Like, that's like what the game was born with. I don't see why,
but
it makes people unhappy.
It's mainly because they never played anything that's like dice roll heavy, you know? Like, they play games and it's like they expect something or like whatever.
And people complain about Nurgles being AoE?
Yeah.
If bashy teams are considered, they're actually kind of fragile.
It's a thing, isn't it, basically? The people will complain no matter what you do, though. That's kind of the thing. Yeah.
I complain for the side of bullshit. Give me more. I want it.
That's the reason why, you know, like, I'm playing sort of thing. 'Cause if you get salty over every single thing that happens, then you don't deserve to be playing this game, in my humble opinion.
No, you shouldn't play this game because, you know, it's bad for your health.
It's so salt.
High blood pressure.
Yeah, right. Let's keep pushing these guys.
Look off. Intimidation is the key. It was one of my strengths when I was still playing.
So I want you to go here, because I need that Croxacore to knock fucking Saren to die. A horrible, painful, smelly death.
Going for the ball, but can they pick it up?
Push is absolutely fine.
And the thing is about Nurgle's team, when a player suffers a casualty on the entry table, they roll twice and they apply both results.
Fair fight can be
so they get freaking shredded.
There's room in sport for a scrap like this.
With fists flailing, he's following up, hoping to get the knockdown next time.
So what I'm gonna do is get more people around the ball actually. Oh, hey, didn't see that tackle's in there. Never mind.
Oh well, we'll add in garbos and that'll make people unhappy.
Goblins are fun.
I know, but people, I don't know why, but people rage when secret weapons are pulled out against them.
Oh, and the death roll is perfectly fine, is it? Having a fucking...
Oh, that's...
Oh, just knocked out another siren.
What's the point?
Nice! I seem to be having more luck with the siren than I am against the skinks killing them, so...
That player is shuffling off the field.
Oh, you know, Nephil chooses what Nephil wants.
Oh, he picked up the ball. Nice!
This is like 160% jank. I've never seen so many siren go down.
Well, you know... You're like, oh, go for the skinks. I'm like, okay, got it, boss.
But you did get two skinks.
I know.
Well, three skinks, actually.
I'm like, okay, got it, boss.
They're not going to be able to pick up the ball.
But that was the funniest thing about it, though, you know? It's just kind of like, oh, yeah, you know, just...
That's it. Force them back, and then pow!
You have blocks, so you're going to die. Right, come on, cow.
To lay out an opponent of
that mighty
strength.
Blow. Let it happen.
The bigger they are,
the harder they punch.
Kill this star player. That's all I ask of you.
I only ask for you to do the best you can.
Yeah, right. God damn it. Oh well. Oh, a pow. Nice.
Well, you're getting pretty good rolls.
Yeah, I'm not counting my chickens, so.
No, it's time to start counting.
They can't catch me if I... Well, they definitely can't get to me, so I'm going to put you over here. Because of reasons. Just in case. But, you know, I've left one guy near... their end zone kind of thing, because if you notice that they're running out of players, like, you know.
And the thing about Soras that makes them balanced that a lot of people don't seem to understand is they have no, they can't dodge.
Right,
the agility of one, they're not going to pick up the ball, they're not going to pick up the ball.
You would need, like, you need break tackle with a Soras,
yeah,
wouldn't you?
Definitely. Up,
parts of the stadium would collapse, killing many fans.
But that's me getting off my soapbox, because I've seen too many people in the forums complaining about the lizard men.
I don't understand why. They've been around for, like, forever.
Yeah, but, you know, this game doesn't have as many as the previous edition, so I've heard, so people complain about it.
But most veteran players would know this.
There's been a big influx of new blood in this game.
And that's where the salt is coming from, probably.
Don't worry, they'll either get the salt will either, like, calcify, and they'll become normal players, or they will just leave.
that signifies a great.
And the thing about them leaving is it's not 100% a bad thing because, A, they're the people who are just rage quitting games.
I fell a GFI twice. Just thought I'd mention this.
Nuffle taketh away.
Oh, you're gonna die, Skink. You're gonna fucking die. At least the ball scattered the correct way, which is the surfing way.
But God, Skinks are fast. Smells weakness.
Oh, hell yeah, they're fast, but I didn't think one go for it, like a 1 out of 6 chance would be bad, but apparently it is.
1 out of 6? No, man. It's more like 2/3 of a chance of failing.
Really? It's like 83% chance of success. That's 1 out of 6, isn't it? If you roll a 1, you fail your go for it, don't you? That's
not
how it
when
works.
You need it.
Oh, well, true. Okay, let me... But even then, I decided to re-roll it, and it was like, nope.
You know what I'm definitely waiting on? Sorry for interrupting. You know what I'm definitely waiting on? For that skink just to stab your minotaur and kill him.
Yeah.
I can see that happening. It's just bullshit enough to happen.
Why do you think I keep punching him out of the... I keep punching him into dust. There's another KO. Time to get stamped on, my friend. How dare you try to pick up the ball? That was my ball. Oh shit, it's going into the end zone. Nice!
Wow, he KO'd him before he even went to the crowd. Two injury table rolls. Nice.
Yeah, but guess where the ball is now?
Oh yeah, which Ram needs it?
This guy, Stephen Fry up. If he fucking picked... This guy is so garbage half the time. If they were vulgar. The
player could spit into the end zone. Stop, you're going to hurt his feelings.
Okay, I need to score. Like, if you fail this go for it, I'm going to fire you, Stephen Fry up. Thank God for that.
He knew his job was on the line.
Oh, God. He could level if he gets a man of the match, but...
Or if he can get one more touchdown. I don't see it happening, but could. Stranger things have happened.
Let's see how many of their guys get back up, because I knocked out a fuck ton of them. Only two, and it's their skinks. Great!
Oh, well.
The Saren didn't get back up. So, they are severely underpowered now. So, if we... Team's apothecary must have the magic sponge this time. Oh, we so need to kill these guys. The ball to the opponents. Now it's time to think defensively. Well, you have blocks, so you're going on the line. You also have blocks, so you're going over here.
Well, so far your team's getting stronger, and they're going to start mutating and getting skills.
I mean, it's always a bit of a chance at the start, isn't it? Like, I mean, like, because they're so vanilla at the start, they don't have any real skills or anything like that, but they get very...
Chaos team really starts to pick up around level 2 and level 3 on most players. Then it's like, oh, geez.
Yeah. And I'm leveling them up, like, rather sort of, you know, evenly, so to speak.
Because that claw, when you get claw on some of your guys, oh my god, the damage.
Yeah. This claw and mighty blow will absolutely ruin anyone's day. Like,
quick and easy. Nothing to see here.
Those skinks, let me count the ways that I'm going to murder you.
Like, if you don't want to have a block guard Chaos Warrior, you can go block mighty blow claw. Mm. That's mean. That's I want to put you on the ground. Building a cage around
the ball here. I'm definitely going to have some murder pieces, I think, because otherwise it wouldn't be a real Chaos team, would it, really?
I would say make one of your Chaos Warriors a murder piece and then have three that have block and guard.
If I can get one with strength, I'm definitely going to do a murder piece. Like, if plus one strength, because then that would help out like a fuck ton. But...
Oh yeah, you always take stat ups on your Chaos Warriors. Any stat ups. Because they're so well-rounded. Because, I mean, think about it. Even if you got, like, a Chaos Warrior who got extra agility. That would put him up to 4 agility. That's elf agility.
Yeah.
And then you just got a Chaos Warrior that can dodge between tackle zones.
Rise from your grave. Alright, don't rise from your grave. God damn it. Alright.
He don't feel like it.
He didn't. Rise from your grave. Nah. I'm gonna stay on the floor, thanks. Stroking him
on his belly. Nah, man. They're gonna just hit me again if I get up.
Oh, I didn't want that roll. I got a re-roll.
You got 2 left and there's only 3 turns.
Yeah, I know.
You've gotten much better about using your re-rolls. Better.
Because I want these two guys to rush the skinks, basically, so... That's what they're going to do, I think.
Oh, man. If you can get that Chaos Warrior leveled up this game, it'll be a very productive game for you.
That's why I'm going to rush with him, I think, because you've just made a very valid point. I was going to do it with the Horned guy, but... Ah, pow. Nice. Cool. All right. So, what do we do now? First of all, say hello to Mr. Skinky boy over here.
They're getting up close and personal. Maybe you'll get lucky and you'll get an MVP on your Minotaur in 2 games. Smell your breath and see the
dead insects in your teeth. Possibly. I mean,
because when your Minotaur levels up, he becomes devastation.
Oh shit! I didn't mean to do that. Whoops. I'm going to keep you backfield, actually, because I don't want them scoring on me. I don't I don't like it.
There's still a chance they can, too.
I know. So keeping one backfield is not, like, the dumbest move I've ever made. I've made plenty, but...
Just for the fact that they can move 8 pieces, that's gutter runner territory. One below.
And have you noticed? The cow is nowhere near the guy that can stab and murder me straight away.
Think about it. If you lose your cow, that's the biggest piss off in the world. Because yeah. It's like, there goes your money.
Yeah, all 150k. How very close. Smells like
a fight is about to happen. Plus, the cow's armor is surprisingly low for a big guy.
I might give him, like, plus armor value if I can. Ooh, these are all dub skulls. Nice. Oh, that wasn't so nice.
Because they only have an armor value of 8. I mean, it's good, but could be better.
I'm a value 8, it's like orc territory though, which is not bad.
Yeah. It will finish in the public. And the thing about fans are much more dangerous. The Minotaur is going to take a stat increase, I'd say only armor or strength. Any other stat for a Minotaur is worthless. Well, I wouldn't say worthless, but it's not optimized, I'll put it that way.
Okay. Can I do some really strange bullshit? How far can you move? Look. Click him. Could you move, please? Hang on, let me deselect. And blitz, maybe? I might be able to get a touchdown. Put some pressure on the ball carrier. Oh, he's got sidestep. Of course he has. Shit, I forgot about that. Alright, never mind. That player is so close
to a world of hurt. Sidestep's good on your skinks. You don't want people surfing them.
No, I think that's the reason why they have it, right?
Yeah. One more step in.
I'm going to leave the countdown. Possibly the smart move, because... Getting him back up just means he's just going to get punched in the face again, right?
There's only one Sar around him. I would say it's probably worth it to pick him up just to get some rolls off.
Well, it doesn't matter. He rolled the tech it down anyway. Well, hello.
Oh, get up, there you go. Get off the
field. You stunned? That's... So what does stab do? Is it just literally like it ignores armor value and then you just go into the... critical roll table or something. How does stab actually work?
the ability. Let me think. I'm opening up my book. One second. Second, going down the table of content. Okay. A player may attack an opponent with their stabbing attack instead of throwing a block at them. Make an unmodified armor roll for the victim. If the score is less than or equal to the victim's armor value, the attack has no effect. If the score beats the victim's armor value, they've been wounded with an unmodified injury roll must be made.
Oh. Hard to make them lose the ball. Okay, that's interesting.
But casualties made with a stabbing attack does not count for star player points.
Oh, so it's kind of like fouling when they're up, right? So.
Yes.
Ah, okay. All right, that makes sense. See, when it's put to me like that, I'm like, oh, I get it, sort of thing. It's like, oh, you're just fouling someone, but they're standing up. It's like, yeah, sweet. Oh, Jamaican jerky. No.
Yeah, well, you pretty much won this game.
I don't think there's much they can do, right?
No. They're not going to get down the entire field in one turn. They don't have pass. They don't have a pass game like, they don't have the pass game like elves, so you've won.
Well, I did just get like a dub skulls, and then I re-rolled it because, you know, I had one re-roll left.
Oh, double skulls. If you re-roll it in double skulls, that's always the funniest thing ever.
Yeah, what? Quad skulls, basically, yeah.
Yeah.
But that was, you know, uneventful, I suppose. Right, get up. Yay! So I know they can't hurt him anymore, so.
God, sidestep's so good.
Yeah, tell me about it. Sidestep and fend are like some of my favorite skills. But then again, if you get grab, I think it's grab, isn't it? It ignores... You get to, they don't get to sidestep you, right? Is that correct? I think it's, or is that dodge?
I believe it's grab.
Yeah. I know there's like things that like negate sidestep, but.
See, I think grab's a strength skill, but let me check. It is a strength skill. And the player gets to choose where to push after a block. And, yeah.
This is going to be decisive.
So basically, grab is the strength version of sidestep.
Oh, Welsh rare rabbit. He just got his ass knocked out. Well, at least no one's died this time, or got fatally injured, which means...
No stab has succeeded.
Yeah, well, no stab has succeeded, but it also means all of my players are going to be in for the next game, which is fantastic. Which means, you know, more chance of SPP.
Within grasping range of the fans, and they're looking hungry.
Well, that's GG, I guess. Which is fair enough.
Just thank your stars, the skinks out of a passing game.
But to be fair, they couldn't really get down there, could they? To pass it, I mean, like
Stunty. I thought my heart would almost may decrease their ability to pass, but... If they could run through all those tackles out, you better believe they could do something. Like, for your next team, I highly suggest you play Lizardmen. They are fun. That's why a lot of people play them.
Yeah, yeah. I got 50k that time, so that's not too bad.
Yeah, 50k is... I think it's rolling on a d6.
Yeah, it is, I think. I think 60k is, like, the best you can get, right?
Yeah, top. See your star player.
Monster Munch, your star player. He's level 3 now, I believe.
Well, there you go. You got a damn good blitzer.
Well, let's see what we can do with him, shall we?
Not blitzer. He's level 2.
Oh, it's Skaven again.
Well. Just try to get your injuries off on them. And you're coming in with more players than you did last time.
That's true. That's very true. All right, so let's go into our team again for a moment. Our value is going up like quite well, I think.
Yep, level ups and cash, not bad.
Okay, so one's going to level 3 and the other one's going to level... Welsh Were-Rabbit is actually going to level 2. So what do you have block? I'm pretty sure of it. So let's level up and see what you get.
Mighty Blow is what I recommend, or
I got dubs. I got dubs. Yeah.
Let's...
8.
Huh. Well, let's see then. What would you want? I'm thinking.
How's the mission?
Maybe jump up?
I'm thinking jump up, yeah.
She took everything in the divorce, including my family.
Jump up or sidestep, actually. I'd probably put jump up a bit above sidestep.
Yeah, because he's more likely to get knocked down, isn't he, being a...
Or sidestep, actually. Sidestep's really good. That's... It's your call.
He's more likely to be a murderous bastard later on, though, isn't he? So, like, jump up would actually... If he gets knocked down, he'll get back up again. So, like, he can always sort of go to the next guy, I suppose. It would be useful to have a jump up guy, you know, just in case.
Or sidestep, so you get to choose where they're knocking him, so you don't get knocked away from your other players, and you can keep more dice block on them. Especially if you get guard on a couple more of your Chaos Warriors.
I think... Dodge would be better if you have guard already. Sidestep, sorry. I think sidestep would be better if you had. What I'm thinking is that, like, if I had a guard piece with sidestep, I could maneuver him around, right? So, like, he would still be effective. I'm going to pick jump up, I think. I think that's going to probably be the best idea for at least this guy, anyway. He's...
So you can give him Mighty Blow or Claw next?
Well, Claw gives everyone minus 7 armor, 7 armor value, right? So they could be, everyone becomes squishy, which means you would level up quicker if you get onto the
Did you know
Singy Roll. Mighty Blow is plus 1, isn't it?
Players have to be careful. I believe so, yes.
The highest prices are for limbs and other body parts.
Actually, let me check it out.
Are not bothered Mighty about Blow. Waiting for the target player to perish before harvesting.
Mighty Blow is plus 1 to an armor injury roll, and Claw is everyone has 7 AC. So to get onto the injury table, Claw is probably going to be better, and then you get Mighty Blow in that order, probably.
Yeah, Claw is for automatic armor breaks, and Mighty Blow is for bonus damage.
So I'll get Claw first, because you would get Claw first.
Unless you wanted Mighty Blow to get on the injury table quicker. It depends on how you want to try to level them up. Like, Claw is good because it breaks their armor lower, but Mighty Blow adds extra, so it would turn a stun into a damage.
Okay, Welsh Were-Rabbit, you got dub ones.
Okay, so he's got dub ones.
Mm-hmm.
Give him leader. Give yourself an extra reroll.
That's in general? No.
Oh. I think leader's in passing.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, there you go.
They've got
all right,
so
well,
many
I'm getting
called
away. I'll catch you
later.
Latest, man. Have a good one.
I don't trust all my life, Jim. I don't see why I gotta take notice of him now.
All right, so that was it. Our team has leader and a guy with a jump up. So we've all two doubles. In one thing, we've got 50k, which I don't think we can do anything with, because rolls are very expensive. Don't need anything else, because cheerleaders, no one wants cheerleaders. But we're getting our stuff back. Let's see what the leaderboard is doing. The Chaotic Crisps are at top. We've got like ridiculous TB now. The Immortal Hawks, the Wood Elves, the only other ones that are actually like sort of doing some level ups, but we've not lost a game yet, which is great. So that's going to be the end of this one. Thank you all for watching. And,